You're listening to the Best Morning Routine Ever podcast, the show that proves no one stumbles upon success ever. With your host, Lou Need. Every Mondays and Thursdays, we deliver cold hard evidence behind the power of a robust morning routine. Get ready to be transformed by the renewal of your mind.
Hello, morning enthusiasts. Welcome to the Best Morning Routine Ever podcast. I am your host, Lou Need, and today I have the honor of introducing a very special guest to the show, Stephen Sonata. Stephen struggled with addiction and alcoholism for almost a decade before hitting rock bottom in 2011. Riddled with negative thoughts and limiting beliefs in 2012, he applied to law school. Got rejected, but he did not stop trying because Stephen did get into law school the following year. I was blown away when I read this from Stephen last week. He said his morning routine literally transformed his life. It took him from a scared law student aiming to survive to a committed law student who graduated valedictorian. It was simple and powerful, he said. Creating a morning routine, he believes, is one of the greatest gifts we could give ourselves. It changes everything. And he is absolutely right. It's one of the first things he himself works with when he's coaching his clients. After graduating law school, Stephen went on to practice corporate law at one of the best firms in the world, yet he was still searching for something. There was something missing. He wanted something different, and he wanted to add value in a more profound way. So today, Stephen is one of the well-sought-out coaches in the New York area. Stephen, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. And I am so appreciative of the introduction. Thank you.
My pleasure. I am thrilled to have you on board because we're going to discuss today organizational development, emotional intelligence, and your morning routine, of course. So tell us a little bit about your journey.
Okay. Let's see what I can fill in that you haven't shared. So first, I'm so excited to be here and to share some of my experience and some of the teachings and wisdom I have that can really make a difference in someone's life. Yeah. So my journey, like you said, I grew up in New Jersey. I'm the last of four children. I grew up in a very fun and musical household. My mom had a dancing school in our home, literally. So I grew up with a lot of dancing and music and loved that. And that was a big part of my life. And I even got to perform professionally for a while. My life took a turn when I began to use alcohol and drugs to handle life's challenges, emotional pain specifically. Mm-hmm. And that led me to creating a very self-destructive solution to life's challenges. And I ended up creating my own hell, a place where I wouldn't wish upon anyone. It was very painful.
Yeah. Yeah.
And there were points I didn't want to do anything, right? And I didn't care if I didn't wake up. It was like that, to be completely honest. And fortunately, I had a divine moment where I saw myself from an outside perspective and was really surprised and definitely not pleased with who I had created myself to be. That was enough, thankfully, to snap me out of it. And when I got into the present moment, I made a decision. Like, I was going to stop. That was it. I was going to be done with the drugs and addiction. And I stopped and I went through a grueling withdrawal. Though I did not stop drinking. I really honestly did not consider I had a drinking problem.
No, right.
Even through the fight.
Right.
Even through the car accidents. I did not think I had a drinking
problem.
You
were a functioning alcoholic.
I was.
I used to call myself that too when I was drinking, so I can relate.
Yeah. It's wild, especially when we're in an environment where it's like the norm. Mm-hmm. You know, it doesn't seem out of place. So I kept drinking and that got worse and worse to the point where I totally hit bottom. Mm-hmm. In December of 2011 when I went out with some friends and decided and sincerely believed I would not drink that night. And so I decided to drive. And as you can probably suspect, I did drink.
Yeah.
Not only did I drink, but I blacked out.
Oh.
And I drove home and smashed my car into a huge tree.
Wow.
Totally annihilating my vehicle. Yet I walked away miraculously unscathed.
Wow.
A total miracle. That was one of the best nights in my life.
Divine intelligence had a different plan for you.
Yes, divine intelligence had a different plan for me indeed.
And you've been sober for 8 years now.
Yeah, yeah, coming up on 8 years. I had a relapse after 7 months. So July 4th is my sobriety date, July 4th of 2012. Which is when, God willing, I'll celebrate 8 years.
Congratulations. That is a milestone, a big one.
Thank you so much.
And so today you are doing coaching.
I'm now a professional coach. I have my own coaching business. So after I got sober and cleaned up my act and started to learn about myself and how to love myself and how to be of service and how to function in the world as a sober person is when my dreams started to come back, one of which was to attend law school.
Yeah.
And so that's when I applied, like you said, got rejected and kept going and applied the next year and got in. Graduated from law school, first in my class, went on to practice law in New York City and transitioned from law to coaching.
Yeah.
And that is where I am now. I love it. I have a full practice. I work with executives, doctors, mental health professionals, law students, college students, high school students,
wow,
a wide range of extraordinary individuals. And I am completely fulfilled by the work I do.
Well sought out. Stephen, I want to talk to you briefly about something you mentioned. You said you didn't like the life you created for yourself when you were, right, when you were drinking and intoxicated and under the influence. And I know there was a transition for you while you were on the train to school in the morning. You would listen to motivational stuff. You would transform your mind. You would renew your mind. Tell us about what that process was like for you.
Yes, that was one of the most profound transformations of my life. Before I started law school, the weekend before classes started, I went to see my friend and judge speak at his church, and he shared about his story of overcoming incredible odds to become the Honorable Michael Wright. And I was so touched. I was so moved. I was so inspired by his speaking. I remember feeling this energy that I had never felt. And I wanted more of it. And I decided to make a commitment. And I decided to use all of those years that I, quote unquote, wasted, uh-huh, drinking and drugging, and use them as fuel now to create a much better life. And so I began listening during my morning commute to some of the world's best inspirational speakers.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't know at the time what I was actually doing. Now I can see it in hindsight. But what I was doing was totally rebuilding my mindset.
Right. Right. Who was on your list? I love Les Brown. I love Tony Robbins.
Yes. You just pinpointed two of my top as well. Les Brown, Eric Thomas.
Uh-huh.
Those were my top two at that time. Les Brown's work especially really spoke to me. And I remember he has this one talk where he's like, there was someone who came to his school at an assembly and he was inspired by it. And he went up to the guy afterwards and he said, I want to be successful and I want to buy my mom a house. Can I do that?
Mm-hmm.
And the guy said, that's possible. And he said, yeah. Yeah, you remember me. I'm the one.
Mm.
I'm the one. I always remember that. And those words always echoed in my mind. And I carried them with me. Like, I'm the one. I'm going to go for number one. I'm the one.
Mm.
I'm the one. And it began to shift how I viewed myself and what was possible for me in my life.
Yeah, that you're the one. You are in charge of your destiny. You create your future. You create your tomorrow. Like, your thoughts became your reality. You realize that.
Yes. Yeah.
And so because negative thoughts, as we have them, you said you were riddled with negative thoughts, but we have every one of us, we have ants, what I call automated negative thoughts. Dr. Amen coined that. And he's absolutely right, because we were socially constructed. We've been downloaded this program that is not ours. It's not positive. It's self-sabotaging. So it really takes the work, the grunt work, to actually reprogram ourselves. And it starts with owning who we are and loving ourselves like you did.
Yes. Yes. Oh, my gosh. I love the term. And that's exactly it. I was, before law school, I was riddled with ants. I had so many limiting thoughts and beliefs that prevented me from greatness.
Yeah.
And by shifting those thoughts and beliefs about me, what I'm capable of and what's possible and what I'm willing to do to go all in, it transformed my mindset internally and my world externally.
Right. Yeah. Jim Rohn says, if you change, your world will change. It's beautiful.
Yes, I would 100% agree with that.
Now you've gone through the grunt work. You did the work. You even went to school, and now you are one of the well sought out coaches. You're teaching organizations, big organizations, doctors. Tell us about the leaders and entrepreneurs that you're teaching, and how you are helping them and their organizations.
Yeah, well, I've come to learn through my experience, research, and coaching that happiness and success are more of an inside job. And so what I work on with people primarily is the internal work, coming to discover some of our ants, some of the negative and limiting beliefs and perceptions, and really getting present to what's happening in the mind and rewiring and creating conversations that offer new language and a new way of thinking to help us to create these fundamental shifts in thinking that help my clients feel happier and better than they've ever felt. And that translates into high level performance.
Absolutely.
All of their interactions change at home and at work, and how they show up at home and at work completely transforms as well.
Mm-hmm. Because they value themselves, right? More.
It's all, yeah, right. It's a lot of it's about self-love. Everything, you know, creating a life we love is about loving ourselves, creating a mindset where we feel great and perform at our best, not just try or think about being our potential. We literally be our potential. Mm-hmm. It's a way of loving, expressing self-love.
Yeah. As you're saying that, I'm thinking to be able to show up in their family, in their businesses, there has to be some work around EQ, right? Emotional intelligence, to be able to assess their own emotions and be aware of themselves, and then actually regulate them, not just their emotion, but actually other people's.
Yes.
What's that conversation like that you have around with individuals?
Yes. Oh man, it's one of my favorite topics. Emotions are one of the most powerful forces on the planet, and we can use them to our advantage. So one of the things, and this ties in really well to a morning routine, one of the things I ask my clients when they come on board is, what are the first 30 to 60 minutes of your day? Or what does the first 30 to 60 minutes of your day look like? And if I don't see something in there that's cultivating a mindset, certain emotions, and it's an area we can begin working on right away. This is one of the areas, to me, it's like low-hanging fruit in an area where we can make a profound difference immediately and create transformative results. I even gave a presentation Tuesday night for the New Jersey Association of Legal Administrators, and we dove into this as well. And so we start with the question, okay, what mindset would you love to create each morning? And when I say mindset, I use that synonymously with emotional state, because to me, they're very correlated. And say, okay, how would I love to feel? I'd love to feel inspired and grateful and a sense of love and peace and energy and motivation. Okay, now we know how we want to feel. Now we have an awareness of which emotions we would love to cultivate. What can we do to cultivate that mindset? And this can be personal. It can be really simple. Like mine, when I was in law school, I just hopped in my car and hit play and listened to emotional videos. And I achieved that, which is a very simple and effective morning ritual. And so we'll begin to create a personalized morning ritual for them to that will cultivate the mindset that they would love to cultivate. And from there, it transforms how they show up in the world and transforms and creates desirable results.
So it's tying, you can visualize, you can say affirmation, but it's useless if you don't have the emotion tie into it. Because as you said, emotions are the big key here.
Yes, huge key. And the more aware we can become of our emotions, the more we grow in our capacity to intentionally cultivate our emotions and regulate our emotions.
Yeah, and you get better and faster results that way, because I have an app coming out, because after talking to a lot of these great entrepreneurs, I have found the 9 common things that come up that entrepreneurs do in the morning. So I, as the data analysis that I am, I bundled that up in an app and that's coming out for my listeners. And one of the things that's in there is visioneering. It's visualization, but with a twist, adding the emotional piece into it. So you first relive a moment where you were happy, you know, like falling in love, the birth of your child, being a great speaker and getting the accolade for it, speaking for the first time. And then you take that winning feeling and then you carry it to a future goal. That's the emotional piece of it. That way the body is saying, I've already felt this, I've already achieved this. And then it will it'll come to you a lot faster.
Yes, I do the same thing. And that is exactly it. That's a thing, an activity. It's like an action we can do to cultivate a certain state.
Yeah. Yeah, you can get into alpha state within 45 seconds.
If you get into
alpha state, you are actually so prepared. You're at that relaxed state where you're not even trying, and the mind is so relaxed that you can attract and actually bring to you anything you want. It takes 45 seconds.
Yes, I would agree. I have a really quick story to share about one of my clients who transformed his life immediately.
Tell us.
We took a look at his morning routine, and one of the first things he was doing was diving right into the news, which is so common. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying like be blind to what's going on, but I'm saying diving into the news will create a certain emotional state. One, usually with disturbance.
Fear,
totally. Yep. Fear, disturbance, not a very powerful state of being. So once we could identify what was going on and just remove, we removed his news app from his phone completely. And we put in some exercise, some clean eating, and some infusion of positive and empowering content into his mind. And it changed his life radically in a very short amount of time. When we began working together, he had a lot of anxiety and fear. And now he's like one of the happiest, most peaceful and powerful persons I know.
Nice. I love hearing stories like that. I do.
Yeah. Such a powerful testament to a morning routine, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And it's a great segue. How do you get up, dress up, and show up? What's your morning routine like?
Yeah, me personally. So it has evolved. Right now, what I love to do when I wake up, I go into prayer, and it's usually a prayer of gratitude. And I love to just be present to, I can breathe. Ah, so happy and grateful that I can breathe. My heart's beating, this incredible organ pumping life through my body. And I just get really present to my life and to my health. And I thank God for another day to live and make a difference. And I also say, whatever your will is for me, God, I'm willing to do it. And then I'll take some time to drink my pre-workout drink, which gives me some energy. I'll read a little bit, usually spiritual growth text or personal growth text. And then I love to work out. And while I work out is when I'll listen to something that's inspirational, motivational, enlightening, or the like. And by the time I'm done with that, I feel incredible.
You're ready to go. That's just 4 items on your list. I was counting. And you are ready to go with just four. And it's profound because I want to share with you what else I found in the as I've been studying and taking data with entrepreneurs. That gratitude journal is key, and it happens every morning. And for you, it's just, you know, it takes a few minutes to just say, you know, I'm thankful for these organs that are running without without my help. You know, yeah. I'm grateful to be awake, to wake up, to have breath. And it's that simple moment that actually sets the tone for the rest of the day that you'll find more things to be grateful for throughout the day. You have this positive energy with you throughout the day, and it's pretty phenomenal. And reading something stimulating, yes, I make it a thing to read half hour in the day. And if you read 30 minutes a day, and I tell my listeners, by the end of the year, you would have read 36 books. And wow. So you think about that, right? It just half hour, being disciplined, being consistent with it, half hour a day. And that I do that. And it's part of the app as well. Gratitude journal is part of the app. Reading is part of the app. Working out is part of the app. And so you're hitting it right on the nail, stimulating content.
Yeah, I've done my research too. I love it.
You're adding to my data, Stephen. You're confirming my data. So I cannot wait for this app to come out, because I want to get in the coaching realm as well and teach people how to do their morning routine effectively. And then being able to tailor it to work for them. And yours is short and sweet, but you got the fundamental point in there.
Yes, that's it. Short and sweet, effective and powerful.
And so you can dress up, show up to the world and add more value, because that's what's important. That's the end goal. You have a purpose. You've been given a purpose. You've been given a second chance at life, and you're not going to waste it any longer. You need to add value to as many people as possible. And you're doing that. You're priming yourself so you can be healthy enough to do so.
Right on. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yeah, it's great. Tell us, how can we connect with you?
You know, I was thinking about this, and I haven't done this before, but I'm going to share my number. If anyone wants to connect, they can call or text me. My number is 973-216-4059.
And then the email address, your website, right?
My email address is coach@stephensonato.com. And my website is stephensonato.com. And that's spelled STEPHENSAINATO.com.
Perfect. Thank you for sharing that. I will add all that. So everyone, on the show notes, so people have access to it. So just a brief recap, Stephen, for the audience, happiness and success, you said, is an inside job. I love that. I love that. And I will, with your permission, will want to use that again, because it nails it. It's like right on.
Please, sure. Yeah, absolutely. I'm so glad that resonated.
It did. And your morning routine is prayer, it's gratitude, it's you know, reading and exercising, right? It encompasses everything to set you up for success throughout the day. So I really appreciate you sharing that. And I love that how when you work with your team, you talk about the EQ, the emotional piece of it, to tie that, to have emotions tied to your goals, to have emotion ties to your outcome, to because that drives faster and better results.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. Anything you want to add?
To two things. One is that the more aware we become, and the better we become at managing and cultivating our emotions, the better we become at becoming aware of others and managing others. And having that level of awareness is wonderful for creating deep connection and strong relationships, and for being an effective communicator. Mm-hmm. The other thing I'm present to is just finding our purpose and creating work that really makes us come alive. And one thing that I did that I skipped over in my story that I want to share before we complete is that for a little while, I kept a list of moments in my life when I felt full of joy and gratitude and love and excitement and inspiration. Whenever I felt really good, you know, those moments when you just feel so alive and happy and joyful, your body is almost buzzing. Those moments, I would just write down what I was doing in my phone. And I had this list that were like clues to finding and living my purpose. And they ultimately pointed me in the direction of where I am now coaching.
I'm jotting it down, capturing your experiences.
Yes, exactly.
Thank you for sharing, Stephen. It's been a pleasure having you on the show.
It's been a pleasure being here. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Well, all right, morning enthusiasts, that's it for today's show. Thank you for tuning in. If you love the Best Morning Routine Ever podcast, we'd love to hear from you. So go ahead and subscribe, rate, and give a review on iTunes or Google Play. While you're at it, tell a friend about the show. Be sure to visit bestmorningroutineever.com and our Facebook group to join the conversation, access the show notes, and discover our fantastic free bonus content. Until next time.